that you can start with that. I'm going to start here with this fellow. This is Louis de Broglie. As you can tell from his expression of mildly amused disdain, he's French, and as a PhD student in 1923, he made a remarkable suggestion. He suggested that electrons, which everyone knew were particles, should have wave nature, that an electron should behave like a wave. He did this largely for reasons of mathematical symmetry, because it had already been shown that light waves, which everybody knew were waves, sometimes behave like particles. And he said, well, if light waves behave like particles, maybe particles should behave like waves, too. You know, that's an elegant mathematical argument. It also seems a little crazy. But he had more empirical reasons for believing this as well. If you take his idea of electrons having wave nature seriously, it provides an elegant explanation for why there are these special orbits in atoms that electrons sit in. And this was the basis of the extremely successful Bohr and Sommerfeld quantum theory explaining the states in atoms. So he had reasons for doing this, as crazy as this notion of electrons behaving like waves seems. Once you have this idea, this is also something that is manifestly testable, right? You can go out and you can look for situations where electrons behave like waves. And by 1930, scientists in both the US and the UK had done experiments where they saw unambiguous evidence of electrons behaving like waves. Nowadays, we have a really beautiful illustration of this from an experiment that sends electrons at a barrier with two slits cut in it and detects them on a screen on the far side of the slits, one at a time. Right? And as the electrons arrive one at a time, they show up at a particular place at a particular instant, exactly like you expect for particles. But if you repeat this experiment over and over and over again, all of the electrons together trace out a pattern of bright and dark stripes. This is a signature of wave behavior. Right, and so how is that a signature of wave behavior? Well, we have to look at some actual waves, right? So here's waves in a thing that you expect to have waves. This is a puddle of water that a bumblebee has fallen into. I should tell you that the photographer who took this did note that after taking the photo, he scooped the bee out of the water, so it survived, and so I don't have to worry about that. This bee is in the water. It's flapping its wings trying to get out, and each wing is generating a pattern of waves. You can see them expanding out in concentric rings. Okay. But there's this area in the back where the waves from each wing overlap, where something really complicated and interesting is happening. Right. What's going on there is that the waves are adding together, and the result of adding those waves together depends on exactly how they arrive. If both sets of waves arrive so that the peaks of one are on top of the peaks of the other, then you get a much bigger